You think you know me?
Tell you a story. Once upon a time, a man got fucked. Now, how is that for a story?
Every 30 seconds. And to make matters worse, these dazzling new plantation owners built a pipeline to take our children from school to prison quicker than a cut can bleed. And the lucky ones go from school to the NFL, where they don't even let them niggas take a knee. They've been programmed from birth with shitty food options, contaminated drinking water, gun violence, police brutality, and trauma after trauma after trauma. PTSD, no therapy. Missing, no Amber Alert. Alone.
Now here we all are, 400 year nightmare. Took us 400 years to figure out as a people. And the white people's weakness the whole time was kneeling during the national anthem.
Oh, come, Sergeant.
You should be ashamed. Calling yourself a community that cares.
Oh, but we do care, Nicholas.
It's all about the greater good.
The greater good.
How can this be for the greater good?
The greater good.
How can this be for the greater good?
The greater good.
Shut it!
Why shouldn't you put a toaster in a bathtub full of water?
Because your toast would get soggy. Yeah!
Mink, mink, mink.
Take one step on that rope, and I'll cut it.
Bankai.
I just might have to dig you down on some gangster shit.
Religion has brainwashed us into letting other people steal from us, run over us, and take advantage of us. Religion has brainwashed us into letting other people steal from us, run over us, and take advantage of us.
He told you that you would be first lady, and you believed him. Did I not raise you for better? How many times have I told you you have to be what? You have to be what?
Twice.
What?
Twice as good.
Twice as good as them to get half of what they have. Sleeping with them.
You think you know me?
It would be extremely painful.
You're a big guy.
For you.
It started by me just sitting inside all day. And then it's like, then you get bored. Then you're like, well, I could just be high and I could have a whole adventure in this room. I'm always like, if someone's like, you want to try this? I'm like, yeah, sure. And then it just kind of fucks you up when you have a bunch of money, because like you try a drug, you like it, and you can buy a lot of it, you know. So I went through about everything.
Unpopular opinion part 4. I wish that I lived in the 1940s.
You know, I think it's unpopular for a reason, you know, because in the 1940s an opinion is one of the many things that you wouldn't have had.
I chose my path, you chose the way of the hero, and they found you amusing for a while. The people of this city. But the one thing they love more than a hero is to see a hero fail, fall, die trying. In spite of everything you've done for them, eventually they will hate you. Why bother?
Take one step on that rope and I'll cut it.
But then I thought back to a better me. Before I was a B-list celebrity, before I started calling bitches so heavily. Back when you could get a platinum plaque without no melody, you wasn't sweating me. One time for my L.A. sisters, one time for my L.A. hoes,
Lame niggas can't tell the difference. One time for a nigga who knows. Don't save her, she don't wanna be saved. Don't save her, she don't wanna be saved. Don't save her, she don't wanna be saved. Don't save her, she don't wanna be saved.
He just said what I think he said.
Is this it? This is what I got all those ass whippings for. I had a dream once. It was a dream that little black boys and little black girls would drink from the river of prosperity, freed from the thirst of oppression. But lo and behold, some four decades later, what have I found but a bunch of trifling, shiftless, good-for-nothing niggas. And I know some of you don't want to hear me say that word. It's the ugliest word in the English language. But that's what I see now. Niggas. And you don't want to be a nigga. Because niggas are living contradictions. Niggas are full of unfulfilled ambitions. Niggas wax and wane. Niggas love to complain. Niggas love to hear themselves talk but hate to explain.
So then, she drove back to her place. Oh, you want some of these?
Nah, I appreciate it.
But she took her panties off, threw them on the ground. I looked at them. They was white. But they had some brown spots in them. So I said, what that is? She looked at me. She said, I ain't even gonna cap.
Oh, hell no.
I said, nope.
That's disgusting. Damn, so how'd you get back home? You had the Uber?
What you mean, my boy?
Oh, no.
Got to see it through, my boy.
God yep. Damn it.
I had sex with it.
Today's subject, slavery.
You must got a major ego. I ain't trying to disrespect and trying to play the hero. But when you took takeoff, you took my favorite Migos. Look, I don't know how that makes sense, cause it makes zero. The fuck a wrong place, wrong time, that ain't Gito. Took that man right in his prime, that's playing Evo. When Tiny Lester died, I cried and played CeeLo. Cause I can't even watch Friday without saying Devo. You know this shit got me stressed, right? Staring at the Bible, trying to figure out who's next, like. Why you take the ones who ain't deserving, see what death like. Meanwhile, 6ix9ine free, living his best life. Go back to the day that he took the stand.
Take one step on that rope, and I'll cut it.
I be so in denial, when I'm not happy here. Y'all don't.
My bigger bro, at a point in time spiritually, we was in the same boat, but I wanted to take it slow, he wanted to take it as fast and deep as he could go, pause, yeah we had some problems, but we're brothers, don't show, then I caught a little wave and headed back to shore, and that's when he started drowning, and he had no one around him, so partially I feel it's my fault. That right there is my internal war. The reason why I gotta feel these external flaws. The reason why I can't heal these eternal loss. The reason why I gotta feel this survivor's remorse. And here's a message to this fam. I know y'all got emotional trauma that I understand.
How many stars is on the American flag?
Shit, we got 13 colonies, so 13 minus 50. 13 minus 50, goddamn, 47. 47.
Saucy.
mama told me read the book of Job. They should have called it the book of soul. I came into this hurtful earth in perfect health. Caught Steven Johnson syndrome when I was 10 years old. Internal and external fever, 80% fatality rate at that time, ain't that some shit? Severe pink eye, my eyes swollen shut for like 2 or 3 months and still bright as fuck. Oh, and I even lost my lip skin, grew back darker than its original pigment. Skin disfigured from boils and blisters, unidentifiable by my little sister. Come to think of it, I could have got a crazy check. The shrink thought I'd be traumatized, but I'm a ride. My first years of junior high school were not all right. Them dimes wouldn't give me no time, no, not a nod. I mean, not even you. We eventually got cool, but I was nobody. You was the hottest hottie in the school. Or the world to me, not saying that because I'm your dude. I'm glad I got to watch the woman that you blossom.
We don't give a fuck about him or anyone else like him anymore. They are consigned to the dumpster now. We have reprogrammed reality. Language is a virus, religion an operating system, and prayers are just so much fucking spam.
Okay, well, you're saying all this like I'm supposed to know what the fuck you're talking about.
The dominant fucking paradigm, Shadow.
Because democracy basically means government by the people, of the people, for the people. But the people are retarded.
Assassin's Creed, rapping it back in D, like a mansion that's lacking fees. Tapping the blackest keys, capture catastrophes like a camera feed. Ball like a canopies, fall like Michael Jackson on anesthesia. Mistaken maidens for manatees. Neuralink is now pirating all your fantasies. Mistaken is sanitation for sanity. My mistake, I'm mistaken, staying for cannot leave.
We haven't got all day, truck.
What does that mean?
It means nothing.
Way to go, Trucky!
You do not call me that! There are those on other planets who feel Tamaranians are inferior. Truck is what they call us. You know what it feels like to be judged simply because of how you look?
Of course I do. I'm part robot.
Keep your filthy hands off me, Truck!
You may not value my life, but I still value yours!
I have to admit, you're not bad for a Tamaranian. You must be one of the good ones.
The fact that I rescued you does not make me any better than other Tamaranians.
I think it's time for you to go.
You're just like the trucks.
I'm sorry Valior treated you like that.
There is nothing you could have done. There will always be people who say mean words because you are different. Sometimes their minds cannot be changed. But there are many more people who do not judge others based on how they look or where they are from. Those are the people whose words truly matter.
$1 million, 1993, today is now $2,070,000. Inflation in 5 years will probably devalue half of everyone's money listening to this in their 401ks, IRAs, and their soft saving accounts. Like right now, the world is a wreck, and their only solution to the devaluation is they're gonna have to work harder. Over the last 20 years, 2002 to 2022, salaries have increased 27%, but the cost of a home has gone up 148%. In other words, like, our cost of living in lifestyles is not keeping up. Average person drives a $60,000 a year car that has a $50,000 a year salary with over $100,000 of student debt, 60% of America living check to check. We have a problem. And being busy is not the solution. And getting another job is not the solution. You have to graduate and develop more of the Gen Z millennial mind that says there's got to be a smarter way. It can't be the immigrant way of just work harder, because there is something to say for hard work. But if it's not smart enough hard work, then it's stupid work. It's dumb work. And there's a lot of financial idiots out there that have just not gotten themselves educated.
What did I just see? What did I just see?
Why is everyone so fucking stupid? Why aren't more people intelligent like me?
Serenity, self-control, austerity, purity, forbearance, and uprightness. Wisdom, knowledge, and faith in religion, these are the duties of the Brahmin, born of his nature. Heroism, vigor, steadiness, resourcefulness, not fleeing even in a battle. Generosity and leadership, these are the duties of a Kshatriya, born of his nature. Agriculture, tending cattle and trade, are the duties of a Vaisya, born of his nature. Work of the character of service is the duty of a sudra born of his nature. He from whom all beings arise and by whom all this is pervaded. By worshipping him through the performance of his own duty does man attain perfection. We can see that Hinduism clearly teaches that one's mode of nature is determined at birth, and that not all modes are equal in terms of social standing. While all of the modes are said to be able to achieve salvation, they have to accept their station in society. This millennia-old social hierarchy continues to the present day. The caste system defines which jobs one can do and who one can marry. Over time, those of darker complexions came to be associated with the lower castes, and they suffer severe persecution in society.
But the big story that's breaking at the moment, the urination horror that's taken place in Madhya Pradesh, visual showing an individual who has political links, Pravesh Shukla, urinating on a tribal labourer.
The alleged superiority of light skin over that of dark skin is even reflected in artistic depictions of the Hindu gods, who are typically portrayed as light or blue-skinned. Dark skin is reserved for the evil or scary incarnations of the god, such as Kali. It's important to be fair and acknowledge that positive dark skin depictions do exist, for example, that of Krishna, but they are rare compared to that of light skin depictions. Even revered spiritual leaders such as Mahatma Gandhi was affected by such beliefs. For example, Gandhi was known to have actively supported the ideas of racial segregation during the apartheid in South Africa. He once wrote on the issue saying, "We believe also that the white race in South Africa should be the predominating race."
Keep your answers short and to the point, or I will fucking kill you, or maybe I won't. Maybe I'll just have the children here break every bone in your fucking body. So don't fuck with me.
Got it.
You're working for Wednesday.
Yeah.
Smoke?
No, thank you. Tobacco and it ain't weed. It smells like an appliance fire.
Synthetic toad skins.
Listen, Lee, if you wish to be freed of this suffering, then you're going to need to come to a decision.
Do you mean that I should be prepared to give up on my dreams?
No, because if you lose your dreams, you'll undergo pain far worse than this. You know, the two of us really have quite a lot in common, Lee. Without our ninja way to guide us, you and I would never survive. Get the operation, Lee. You've worked hard, Lee. There's no doubt in my mind your surgery will be a success. You have the power to shape your own destiny. And on the one in a million chance that something goes wrong, I will die right along with you. Ever since the day I met you, my whole nindo has been to make you the most splendid ninja possible. I promise.
Flight. Meanwhile, 6ix9ine free, living his best life. Go back to the day that he took the stand and confessed, right? Tape his mouth shut so he never talked to the fans, like. Make him do his time so his niggas gotta do less, right? Make him learn from Bobby so he can know what respect like. Lord, forgive me for my language and these bad words, but that Candace Owens bitch get on my last nerve. How you gonna tell me that what we witnessed on TV was a murder when we watch niggas turn his ass into Casper? George died from asphyxiation and that's a factor. Fentanyl or not, he'd have never died in his last words. Well, I cannot breathe, so really she gotta chill. Or maybe they should trade places so she can see how I feel. Little bitch got me stressed, God. Probably not prepared for what I'm asking next, God. Bring yay mama back, cause he a mess, God. And he ain't been the same ever since Donda West died. Yeah, that's the day Kanye West died. First his heart, then his mind, then the rest died. And if your bank account is overkill, your soul could be broken still. Even the rich spirit money can't buy. I pray the heavens watch me. Rest in peace, Biz Markie, you got peace. Young Dolph, King Von, Drake in your top three. Black Rob, Troubles, Virgil and Shock G. Pat Stay, Kate Slay, your friend of God G. She almost took Lil TJ, but I'm happy he got Lee. Lord, you even took Black Panther, that's not G. And when Sidda Musavala got shot, that shot me. Begging for your guidance on this ghetto earth.
Can I have some more butter for my pancakes?
That's it.
You are not getting money back. Get out of my way. I have to scam more people. Thank you.
To let you. Shot. Everything I love the most gets taken away. My mama and music is next. And if that happens before I turn 28, then I'm going out with Kurt Cobain. I still believe in God. We just ain't never spoke. Unless we talking symbolically, then I might agree. But if you really want to look at it that way, then hey, man, God don't like me.
Way to go, Trocky.
You do not call me that.
But Valyor calls you Trock all the time.
That does not make it right.
What's up? I thought you said it didn't mean anything.
No, I said it means nothing. When Valyor calls me Trock, he is saying that I am worthless. A nothing.
Star.
There are those on other planets who feel Tamaranians are inferior. Trock is what they call us.
So he's calling you a terrible name. And you know that if you punch him out, it'll just confirm all the bad stuff he thinks about you.
Yes. You know what it feels like to be judged simply because of how you look?
Of course I do. I'm part robot.
Land of opportunity, milk and honey, and guess what? You all get to be slaves. Split up, sold off, and worked to death. The lucky ones get Sunday off to sleep and fuck and make more slaves and all for what? For cotton, indigo, for a fucking purple shirt.
I chose my path, you chose the way of the hero. And they found you amusing for a while, the people of this city. But the one thing they love more than a hero is to see a hero fail, fall, die trying. In spite of everything you've done for them, eventually they will hate you. Why bother?
Right now, we live in such a cycle. I know the past and can foretell our future. It is the same as our history. So we believe that human beings simply cannot understand each other, and they never will. The shinobi world of ours is ruled by hatred, and hatred alone.
Oh, man. Everybody's celebrating New Year's nowadays. You notice this? It's a trend. Everybody celebrating New Year's. Yeah, I'm busy celebrating 2 years. Two more years of Obama, baby, huh?
Yeah. No, it's 4 years. It's 4 years. He's not going to quit halfway through. Well, why are you booing me? I'm right.
It would be extremely painful.
You're a big guy.
For you.
Now I'm not saying Hitler was a good guy. But I kinda wanna know why. I can't even listen to the convo.
my booty hole brown. Where the niggas, I'm looking for the hoes. Quit playing nigga, cause suck a bitch soul.